Hi guys, how are you? I am so excited to be here with you today. This is called Math in a Hoodie, where I put on my favorite hoodie jacket and we talk about math. How exciting is that? I love it. And I'm super excited today because we're going to talk about something. Let's see if you can guess what it is from my hint that I put up on the board. What do you think we're talking about today, guys? I think I heard someone say it. We are talking about telling time. Good job. Yes, we are talking about telling time. And why do you think it's important that we know how to tell time? Why do you think? What do we use time for anyway? What do you guys think? Think about it for a second. Why do we need to know what time it is? Maybe so we know what time to go to bed. Or maybe we have to be to school at a certain time so we're not late. How about if we have to be to an appointment somewhere and we have to be there right on time? Have you ever heard your mom or dad say that? We need to be right on time. Yes, and how would we be right on time if we didn't know what time it was, huh? Okay, or what if we needed to know what time something was gonna happen? What if we were waiting in line for the Easter Bunny to come and they said, okay, it'll be here at 1:30. Well, how would we know what 1:30 is if we didn't know how to tell time? So that's why it's important that we know how to tell time, huh? We use time all throughout the day. And that's how all of us get to work, get to school, make it to appointments, make before a movie starts. We all need to know how to tell time. So we're gonna start with this type of a clock. This is called a digital clock, okay? You have digital clocks or you have the clocks that are in your school where it looks something like that, right? Okay, we're gonna talk about those next, but let's first talk about a digital clock, okay? So a digital clock just tells you what the number is. You don't have to look at the circle clock and try and figure out what time it is. It automatically just tells you. So this tells us 4:29. That's what time it is, 4:29. You might see this type of clock in your car, maybe on your parents or your cell phone. You could see this type of clock on your stove or your microwave. Digital clocks are on a lot of things and they're easy to tell time because it just tells you right away what the time is. Now in the middle of this time are two little dots. Do you know what those are called? That is called a colon. And what it does is it divides the two numbers, doesn't it? Because if we didn't have those two numbers in place, it would just say 429. And that's not really a time, is it? So we use the colon to divide the numbers. So the number before the colon is the hours. That tells us what hour we're in. We're in the fourth hour. The number after the colon tells us the minutes. And that says 29 minutes. See how that divides it up for us? So the first one tells us the hours. Okay. And the second one tells us the minutes. Okay. So this is 4:29, 4 o'clock and 29 minutes. Okay. Does that make sense? Let's try some different numbers and see if we can tell what time they are. Okay, so here's three more times that I wrote down, and let's see if we can figure out what time they are, okay? Now, we know that this is a colon, right? And it separates the hour from the minutes. Do you know how many minutes are in 1 hour? How high could our minutes go? Did you know? Do you know? There are only 60 minutes in every hour. So if you're looking at a clock and it said 2:59, that would mean it's 1 minute away from being 3 o'clock, huh? Because once you hit 60, you go to the next hour. So you would never see a time that said 2:60. No, because 60 equals a whole hour. So that would make that 3 o'clock, okay? So our minutes could only go as high as 59, okay? There's 60 minutes in an hour, but our minutes will only go to 59 because once we hit 60 minutes, it's going to be the next hour. Okay, so let's try and read these clocks, shall we? Okay, Okay, what hour does this one say? 1 hour and 36 minutes. Good job. Let's try this one. 5 hours and 55 minutes. That's almost 6 o'clock, isn't it? 5 more minutes and it will turn to 6. Okay, 11 and 0 minutes. What? What does that mean? That means that it just barely turned 11 o'clock. If it has 0 minutes, that means it just turned that hour. So that's just 11 o'clock. If we sat like this, what time would it be? 10 o'clock. And what time would that be? 12 o'clock. You guys are getting it. See how easy it is? What time would it be if it said 4 hours and 0 minutes? 4 o'clock, huh? So if we don't have any minutes, it just turned that hour. So this is 11 o'clock. This is 5:55, 1:36, and 4:29. So when you read time, you don't necessarily say 5 hours and 55 minutes. You could, but if you say, Mom, what time is it? If she said, oh, it's 2 hours and 10 minutes. That's kind of silly, isn't it? She just needs to say 2:10. So when you read a digital clock, you just say what it says. 1:36. Mom, it's 5:55. It's 4:29. It's 2:59. Or you say it's 11 o'clock. It's 12 o'clock, Mom. See how you do that? Okay, let's go ahead and try our circle clock. Now that you know how to read the digital clock, let's figure out how we can read the circle clock. How do we know what time it is? Let's go ahead and figure that out, guys.